Hello friends, welcome to Susan and John MathTube. We are still on 2076 question paper and we are on question number 12. And this is chi-square distribution. Even though we write CHI, we pronounce chi-squared. It's kind of like KI, chi-square distribution. And the notation is something like this. Now remember, in your syllabus, chi-square distribution is for test of independence and test of more than two proportion. I will show you the entire map of testing. Testing goes like this. Single mean. In single mean, we have large, we have small, we have small sample, but from normal population. Now, two mean testing. In two mean testing also, we have large, we have small, we have paired t-test, and very rarely they ask a question. It'll be from small, large, everything mixed up, but from normal population. But no need to worry. This one and this one, if the population is mentioned to be normal, we always treat that as large. Now comes single proportion. Single proportion, there is only one test and that will be set calculated because it will be always large. Then comes two proportion. Now finally, we have more than two mean. More than two mean testing is called ANOVA test. You can check the playlist. I have already put one video based on ANOVA, or analysis of variance. Here we check the equality of more than two parameters. Similarly, more than two proportion, we use chi-squared test. But in your syllabus, they're asking you to use chi-squared test for testing independence also. And in many question papers, they have asked question based on independence and dependence. Anyway, I'll give you one more tip. Chi-square test of independence will have degree of freedom, number of rows minus 1 into column minus 1, and the proportion test, more than 2 proportion test, will have degree of freedom k minus 1, where k stands for the number of proportions we are comparing. Now look at this. In this question also, they are asking for test of independence. And test of independence means there will be two parameters. Look at this. They are talking about intelligence in BE. And another parameter is economic condition after graduation. So they had 1650 engineers in a survey, and they are classified according to their intelligence and the economic conditions after graduation. And someone wants to test whether there is some sort of dependence association between intelligence in BE and the economic condition after graduation. So they have given four classifications here. He or she was very excellent in BE, good, very dull student, mediocre, good, average, below average, not good, after the graduation. Okay, in all dependence-independence problem, H0 will be the parameters are independent. And H1 will be the parameters are not independent. So, in chi-square test of independence, the null hypothesis will be that the parameters are independent, or we will say they have no association. Remember, in the examination, they may not use the word independence, they will use the word association. Okay, and H1 will be the parameters are dependent. Okay, this is another way of expressing. Null hypothesis assumes that there is no association, that is, they are independent. And alternative assumes that there is a relation between them. Okay, and in exam, don't write parameters are. You just take a look at the question. The parameters are economic condition after graduation and intelligence in BE. In another question, it might be age group and taste of music. In another question, it might be performance in training program and performance in job. So, whatever be the parameters, you just write the parameters here and write they have no association or there is no association between. For example, in this question, there is no association between economic condition and intelligence. That will be null hypothesis and they are connected as alternative hypothesis. Okay, and the level of significance, I guess it is not given. Okay, but the value is given, so that's more than enough. So we go to step number 3. And this is a really lengthy question because they have given 4x4 rows. Okay, I'll make you understand what to do. The calculation of chi-square takes time. So you have to do it very patiently. They have classified like good, average, below average, and not good. So this is the economic condition. And here they have classified their performance in BE. So excellent performance, good performance, medium performance, and dull students. Okay, so now what you do is, okay, here we will write row total. See, we are going to add all these things. So we have row total here, and here I will write column total. So that will give me the sum of the columns. I'll use a different color so that you don't mix it with the question. And here we write the grand total, which is given in the question. Sometimes it will be given, sometimes it won't be given. So here we write the grand total. Okay, so now look at the question. Everything is given here. So I'm going to write 48,199. Okay. So make sure you write down one corner, 48, 199, 181, 82. Remember, the given data is called observed data. That is the collected data. They did it from experiment data collection things, etc. Now we will calculate another thing, that is expected value. That will be denoted by E. So on this corner I am writing the observed value. So we have the observed value means the given thing in the question paper. 80, 73, 65, 89, 86, 51, 51, 84, 81, 185, 190, 105. Okay, now you can write the row total. Okay, row total is you add all these first row. 510, put it in a circle so that you do not mix it with the data. 307, 272, 561. Now column total. CT means column total. 295, 508, 487, 360. Now for grand total, it is safe that you add all these things. You add all these things and you add all the values so that you can be 100% sure that the values that you have written here is correct. So you can check it, like you can add all the row totals or you can add all the column totals and you can add all the values and check whether you're getting 1650. Okay, now what we do is we are going to write the expected value, and for that I want you to make a small box, and on the top of the table in your examination you have to write expected value is given by RT into CT by GT, row total into column total by grand total. I'll tell you how. For example, if I want to calculate this one, I think you can see I put a tick mark. You look at the row total, you look at the column total. Okay, I'll do one thing, I'll put some arrows. Okay, row total multiplied by column total divided by grand total. I hope you got the point. And I got the answer 91 point. You can check it. Anyway, I got the answer 91.18. Okay, now suppose I want to fill here, I should use the row total 510 multiplied by 508, the whole divided by 1650, and that gives me 157.018. And again the same story. Okay, so now what will you do? Row total. Now the row total is different, 307, 295. Okay, 54.89. Now try it yourself. I'll write all the values. In my opinion, asking 3 by 3 would have been really nice. This takes a lot of time. 0.4. Okay, you can check the values. So remember, the value in the box is the expected value. I'll put red color so that you can see. Okay, now don't be too happy. We have to do a long step now. So I hope you understood till here. Now what we do is we are going to calculate chi-square calculated. You have to be very careful. The formula is very simple. O minus E, the whole square, the whole divided by E. I have seen in many exam papers, students make this formula into this one. This is wrong. O minus E, the whole square, will be the numerator, the whole divided by expected value. And if you want the correct answer, do it very, 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 very patiently. I'll give you one example what to do. This is O, this is E. So I write 48, I'll write like this. 48 minus 91.18, the whole squared, the whole divided by 91.18, plus I look at the next value, 199.157. So I get 199 minus 157.018, the whole square, by 157.018. Like this, you do plus, 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 plus. There are 16 terms like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, up to 16 terms. And the answer is 149.504. It takes time, but try it yourself. And if you want, you can find more questions in the handbook and in the workbook. Please do practice 2-3 questions. The questions are in the part 4 exercise of the workbook. Okay, and as usual, step number 4, tabulated value. So we write chi-square tabulated. The format of chi-square is alpha comma. And remember, in chi-square and ANOVA, there is no two tail, one tail. It will be always one tail. And the graph of chi-square, I'll show you. It's like this. Yeah. You can check the graph in the handbook. Alpha comma degree of freedom. Now, again and again, I want to specify something. In test of independence or test of association, degree of freedom will be number of row minus 1 into number of column minus 1. But I feel the person who made the question was very caring. He didn't want the students to make any mistakes, so he gave that value. They didn't even give the significance level or anything. They are given the value directly. Tabulated value is given directly. And see, 9 degrees of freedom. Do you know why 9 degrees of freedom? There are 4 rows, 4 columns. So, degree of freedom will be 4 minus 1 times 4 minus 1, that gives 9. And it's given 16.919. And that means, I have to mark 16.919. And as always, the tail will be reject. And remaining part, accept. Now, what is step number 5? A very easy step. Take the calculated value. 149 is definitely in the rejection part. So we conclude reject H0. That is, we write accept H1. Accepting H1 means, yeah, there is an association between the two variables. That means it's good news. If someone is performing really good in B, according to this research, the economic condition after your graduation will be connected. That means if you are good, then your conditions will be good. If you are dull, that means the condition will not be that good. Anyway, in ANOVA and in Chi-Square, I wanted to practice a lot of questions, because only through practice you will be able to complete these questions within 5 to 10, within, let's say, 10 minutes, in 10 minutes. And in most of the question papers, there will be either ANOVA or Chi-Square. And in some question papers, they ask both ANOVA and Chi-Square. And sometimes they ask, like what you call, explain the, what you call, procedure of ANOVA or maybe Chi-Square or any test. Okay, now 3 more questions remaining. I'll be back with the next video very soon. So till then, my friends,